The troubleshooting DNA sequencing problems. Automated DNA sequencing is one of the most common and normally most robust techniques performed in molecular biological laboratories. Unfortunately, it does not always work, and when it doesn't, it can be very difficult to work out what went wrong. Fortunately, most failed, or suboptimal, DNA sequencing results have only a limited number of causes. Identifying the cause of a poor DNA sequencing result can often be very difficult, as a particular sequencing problem may have many different causes or result from multiple interacting factors. While Trace3 software will automatically scan the traces for many different sequencing problems, and because it works by analyzing the raw data, it can be used with any base caller. The one most of common automated DNA sequencing problems is failed DNA sequencing reactions. How identifying failed DNA sequencing reactions? The base call has only 5 end bases. The trace chromatogram has noisy or messy sequence peaks with low quality scores. The trace can have false peaks that look real and have high quality scores, especially when the trace has been base called using the KB base call TM. Little or no signal in the raw data channels except for leftover dye peaks. The peak heights in the raw channel are below 100. The trace sequence does not match either the expected sequence or any other sequences in GenBank. The causes of failed DNA sequencing reactions. When sequencing plasmid DNA templates, a common cause is not completely removing all the SDS detergent from the mini preparation. Loss of the sequencing reaction products during cleanup. This is a particular problem when using ethanol precipitation cleanup protocols. Too much or too little template DNA, excess template DNA can kill the sequencing reaction, and not adding enough can prevent enough labeled fragments from being generated. The wrong primer was used. This is more common than you might think. Bad water. The water used contains a sequencing inhibitor. This can occur if there is bacterial growth in the molecule hose. Degraded or failed synthesis primer. Oligonucleotide synthesis is chemically complex, and primer synthesis failures are fairly common. The primers, once diluted down to working concentrations, are susceptible to freeze-thaw degradation or DNase contamination. Dead sequencing chemistry can occur if the big diet and chemistry is stored under the wrong conditions, or it is freeze-thawed too many times. Either the TAC DNA polymerase or dye-labeled nucleotides can degrade. Blocked capillary. If this occurs, then every trace using a particular capillary fails. This can be identified by tracking trace quality on a trace-by-trace basis. The poor quality of deoxyribonucleic acid. Sequence a PCR amplified fragment of the plasmid insert instead of sequencing the DNA plasmid. A plasmid mini preparation kit is used. Perform final ethanol precipitation on the kit purified plasmid DNA. This often solves problems with the quality of the template, provided you don't lose the DNA pellet. Loss of sequencing reaction during the cleanup step. This can be avoided by not using an ethanol precipitation protocol to clean up the sequencing reaction. There are several kits that work very well, but they can be expensive. One tip for avoiding the loss of the reaction DNA pellet when using an ethanol precipitation protocol is to add 1 microliter of a 20 mg/mL solution of glycogen, σG1508, to the sequencing reaction before adding the ethanol. This helps make the pellet visible and the glycogen does not seem to interfere with the injection of the sequencing DNA fragments onto the DNA sequencer capillaries. Too much or too little template DNA was used. This can be avoided by checking the concentration of the template on an agarose gel before sequencing. This will also allow you to see the purity of the template DNA and if there is a significant amount of contaminating genomic DNA or RNA present. Do not rely on a spectrophotometer reading to calculate the template concentration. Wrong primer. This is simple to solve but can be difficult to detect. Check the sequence of the primer and template to make sure that the primer binding site is present. This can be a particular problem with some universal forward and reverse primer sequences that do not work with some common plasmids. Do not trust other people's working stock solutions, especially those of your unreliable lab colleagues, and make your own. It might take 5 minutes longer, but it will save you a lot of future headaches. Bad water. Inhibitors can contaminate lab water stocks that can kill DNA sequencing reactions. If you think this may be a problem, then throw out your water and use a fresh stock. Remember, water is cheap. Degraded primer. Don't use old diluted primer stocks. Store the primers in 10 trice, 0.1 liter, pH 8.5, rather than water. Don't use other people's primer stocks. If you have any doubt about the oligonucleotide primer quality, throw it out and make up a fresh working solution from stock. Failed oligonucleotide synthesis. If you suspect that the primer is of poor quality, either has it resynthesized or check the primer in a polymerase chain reaction, PCR. Alternatively, if you have a control template that you know should work with the primer, then this can be a good way of identifying primer problems. Dead sequencing chemistry. This is a relatively rare problem. However, if a batch of big dye chemistry has not been used for some time, or there is any doubt about how it has been stored, then it is advisable to perform a control sequencing reaction before undertaking a large number of experimental reactions. Many problems with dead chemistry can be prevented by storing the big dye chemistry in small aliquots and avoiding repeated freeze, thaw cycles. Blocked capillary can be identified by tracking trace quality on a trace-by-trace basis. While this can be done manually, we recommend using our QualTrace 3 software. If you suspect that a sequencer capillary is blocked, then inform the sequencer operator.